It's that time again for Bleach episode 15 of Core 2 or episode 2, whatever you want to call it. It's a good time because we're going to get into an action-packed episode. I've heard some good things about this episode in terms of just like the staff in general. And yeah, I'm just like excited to get into this. Are we going to see more Bambia? Is it going to be a soy fun episode? And I'm excited. So of course, if you like these reactions, hit me in the comment section down below and let me know. Of course, hit that like and subscribe. And let's get into it. I'm excited. So, yeah, let's go. So, what is the purpose of taking the Bankai? The soul that should be enough for the Shinigami. Really? Okay. There's still more to take. And that is their hope. Okay, so His Majesty expects the captains to have been robbed of their Bankai will immediately learn to how to fight without it. Bambietta, hello? Meninas, Superstar, the moment they believe the possibility that they can beat us without their Bankai even regain it. I mean, they could end it right now if they wanted to, but they want to, like, really, really crush them. Which I think adds, like, a lot to these characters, to be honest with you, and like, the intent. Because, like, we didn't get any of this in the manga, so. Very bad taste, but that sounds like a lot of fun. Exactly, like, these guys are most... She's... he wiped them out, all of them. Yeah. So I really like that. I like the fact that they are already going into this, like, kind of invasion with the idea of, like, we want them to gain hope so we can take that away from them too, even though that they could just completely obliterate them now. Which, considering what we saw from the first, like, invasion, they could. I think it just really speaks volumes about, like, how malicious these guys are, and it makes them feel like actual villains rather than just pawns for Yuha. Okay, and there we have it, the Sekeki. Hey, Kiyone and Oh, he's outside of it. That's interesting. Like, we actually get to find out where that is. So they're like, they all pulled all their reaction together to make like a pocket dimension in a sense, like in the shadows. Yeah, true. They had an endless supply of reaction. Yeah, that's absolutely. Yep. We spent 1,000 years building up our power in the shadows. It just looks gorgeous. Like, everything art-wise is like on point. These camera angles are nice too. He believes that the quicker the battle, the better it is. Because, yeah, he prefers peace, not battle. Like, the irony. A single order, and that is to exterminate that enemy instantly. Let's see how that works. Hey, big Mayuri! Come on, let's see the get up. Here it is. You Quincy's were lurking in the show. It looks like such a good meme there. Hey, I like the sound effects of, like, whatever material he's wearing. Hey, Nemu looking nice too. That's why I modified the inside of our laboratory to not have any semblance of That seems like really hard, to be honest. Fair play though. Okay, we're getting into some multiple battles here, like probably all CG, right? But this is nice. We get to see like, okay, just Basby, just, yeah. He didn't give him a chance. He just literally just AoE'd them. Hey, come on, Toshiro. Basby versus Toshiro. Hopefully this is a good fight. Let's go. Rangiku, Toshiro. Camera angles again are looking nice. Hey, the remix of the OST. Ah, great. It's from the it's from the pre-animated PV. I mean, it didn't look as bad there, to be honest with you, but yeah, like, okay, so this has been changed, as we know. She doesn't get stabbed like she does in the manga, because they wanted to give Omida a little bit of time to shine. So let's see how this is handled. Can Omida really get redeemed, though? Like, that is the question. Like, I don't see it, but, like, I'm here to let it be. Okay, this should be BG9. Let's go. Yep, big BG. What is this script? Will we ever know? Hopefully. Beautiful, like, background and direction here. This is some thin ice you're pulling out. True? The vacuum ice. Why don't you stop resisting and surrender your life? Yeah, that looked alright, actually. I like that. That was a good shot. I was thinking maybe losing your Bankai wasn't so bad after all. Give us the uwu face. This is, like, wholesome, even in the midst of battle. But let's go, Hineko. Let's go, Rangiku. Let's see if you can actually, like, pull through in the Thousand Year Blood War arc. The vacuum. Wall of ice. Let's go. Now, recall it. There you go. Banger. Beautiful. Now that's strategy. I love that when it was in the manga too. Covering multiple eyes, crab eye, honey coat, only a thin layer of eyes, only retrieving honey coat with the sword. Basby's just like, yeah, I don't understand a word you just said. Are we gonna hear like Hyorimaru in this episode, I wonder? I need to make up for it. I trained myself to fight with less ice. But it seems that this little piece of ice is enough to block your flame. Oh, the insulting. He hasn't even used the fingers yet. He's just blasting heat. Be shredded by my blade of ice. Yeah, I don't know, Toshiro. Looks clean, though. Looks clean. Hey, nice. I've had no problems with this episode so far. Like, it's looking really good. I think you've proven that you can compete with Quinty even without your Bankai. Sure. I'm surprised. I thought it was supposed to be like hexagonal, like shapes. I wonder why they chose to change it. I'm glad that we do get to see Kido again. Like, and in the Blood War, we get to see Kido a lot more. I hope we get to see even more of it because I feel like it's an underutilized like ability. Oh damn, Imida! Sheesh! You gotta go. You gotta dip. Anyways, you're gonna get stabbed. This is the third time I've asked this. I'm hoping for an answer. Soy Fon, please. Where are you? I'm not to give out the captain's whereabouts. I'm the kind of guy who'd let that slip out my mouth. Or who wouldn't? Yeah. A third refusal to answer? Then let me ask you in another way. No. Oh, okay. Good job, Imida. I mean, I feel like he could have pierced right through Imida and still got the goal, but... Hey, not the Gatling gun! Let's go! To be fair, that's really close range. So for Soy Fon to be that fast, I'm impressed. That was really close range. Hey, she's looking nice. She's looking bad. Did you think I'd let it stay imperfected? Let's go! Let's see. I've heard some good things about the speed of Soy Fon in this as well, so I'm excited. I mean, I've already... Hey, look at that smug face. Sheesh! Hey. I would have liked a bit more oomph, but I liked it nonetheless. Hey, Nanao though? Not Nanao. Nemu. Nemu though? I get the feeling you'll take too long. I'll pass. Fair enough. I mean, asking is smart, man. He's like, yeah, this guy's going to be too much of a hassle. that's like a flex for Mayuri to be like, no, you can go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's not playing into it. I would like some more time myself to analyze your answer or what? Were you trying to? Yeah, yeah, yeah. I swear, Mayuri and Asken, pretty smart guys, man. The situation is still critical on your side. Yo, I love that face. That was great. That was great. Oh, did man get hit? He did get hit. But yeah, he hasn't even used any of the fingers yet, so that ice ain't gonna last long, which it didn't. Things are about to heat up. You said you could shield my flame earlier. Oh no. Come on, Toshiro. Yeah. Too much heat, fam. We need to regroup. I'll delay him with my Ryujin. A finely woven eye. I do like Toshiro's like creativity in the midst of like being nerfed. Finger. Oh, that's his powerful one, no? No, it's the more fingers he uses. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That looks cool though. Damn. Oh, not so far. Not like this. Oh, she's looking great though. Ooh. Ooh, clean with it. Damn, is this really that Soy Fon? Damn. Hey, that was nice too. At your current level, there's no need to use the Bankai that I took from you. Damn, the disrespect. And the spirit particles were all like gathering as well. Damn. Ooh. That's a lovely shot. I love that. Damn. Oh, damn. Poor Soy Fon, man. She can't catch a break. But she looked good with it, though. Aren't you a captain? Again, it's the little details for me that I'm liking. Oh, yeah, using the mist. I mean, Toshiro, like, he is a prodigy for a reason. And if his fighting, like, strategies aren't showing it, then I don't know what to convince you. I know some people don't like Toshiro, but he is smart. Hey, nice. That looks gorgeous. Hey, Toshiro putting in that work, though. So I can use two. So, yeah, it was the more fingers. Not good. Not good, Toshiro. Not good. Ooh, that is almost panel for panel. I love that. Damn. To leave the captains to those that robbed them of their bankai. Damn, poor Toshiro. Like, and it's still burning as well. It appears that two Ryatsus are gone. Yes, sir. Soifan and Captain Itsugai have. But not Rangiku. They were specifically talking about captains, though. I'm about the only one who can fight without bankai. Hey, Kisuke! Mayuri's like, ah, no, you're not going to end it like that. I did hear that there's a post-credits. I'm not going to say it was, like, the best episode, but it was, like, I think this episode was, like, a great teaser to literally what's about to, like, come later on. I don't know, because, like, we've seen high animated fights, and, like, this wasn't one of those episodes, but it was done so cleanly. Like, it was fluid where it needed to be. And it showed off the impacts of where it needed to as well. Soifan looking great. Toshiro did his bit, showing his strategy, showing why he's a prodigy. I mean, it was one-sided, absolutely. But at the same time, as Harshwald said, it's absolutely one-sided. Okay, back to Ichigo. Good. Like, there is a beginning and there is no end. The stream has ran its course and there is no sound. The swirling colony, the edge of the clouds descends and the vessel is full of harmony. When the vessel is hit, it will succumb to the weight and it will turn into gravel and rock and become dust after being hit by the rain. If he does not become the vessel, there is no way out. What is this heaviness? At this point, there is nowhere else to go and nothing can be granted, and the names of those who will eventually die is placed into sand. Oh, that. Interesting. As I said throughout the episode, I really just can't wait to break down that poem, actually. Like, that's fucking multi-layered as hell. Like, that's exciting. Like, my brain is, like, just fried from that last, like, ending. But as an episode as a whole, it really solidified that these Quincy are playing with the captains. Even with the second invasion, they're letting them do everything that they can just to break that hope. And that's what Harshwald said at the start of the episode. And really solidifying that. Let them do what they gotta do to make them feel like they've done something. To make them feel like they've got an edge. And then just destroy it. And that's what BG9 did. That's what Basby did. And again, the fluidity. And I think, you know, Soifan and Toshiro looked absolutely amazing in these fights. And surprisingly, well, not surprisingly, it just felt like it was so quick. Like, I want to see obviously more. And of course, that ending credits with Ichigo walking down this path, which, by the looks of it, seems to be stretching further and further and further away, is really interesting. But because I always thought it looked pretty small when we saw it in the first episode, but the fact that, like, he's getting crushed as he's walking, I really want to talk about that poem. So I will see you in the review. But tell me your guys' thoughts, of course, in the comment section down below. Please support the channel by clicking the like and subscribing. Hit me with the comment algorithm too, just saying waffle, you know. I'm gonna catch you guys later anyway. You guys, of course, have this fun. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.